Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Android Studio tutorial. So from the last lesson, we have the my application project with the WebView, and here is the activity underscore main.xml, and here is the code. And under the main activity.java, we have implemented the WebView, and we have added the load URL and something like that. So the WebView is not such a silly thing, so we have to discuss it in deep. Also, the WebView is one of the most useful resource among the other things in the Android Studio. So what I'm going to do today is that in the last lesson, I have told that I will be showing in the next tutorial, I will be showing that how to load the WebView from the assets. So today we are going to learn about what is assets. So assets is nothing but simply a kind of folder that can able to store different kind of data files. So we have the resources, which is rest folder. Under that we keep the drawable, which is going to be images and layouts and blah blah blah, many other things we store under the resource folder. So likewise, we are going to learn about how to use the assets and store different kind of activities or things under that. First of all, you have to make sure that you are in the Android view, and after that you have to simply right click on the app or somewhere else, and from here you have to go to the new, and under the folder section you can see the assets folder. Just click on that, and from this pop-up window you don't have to change anything at all. Click on the finish, and there you go, you have the new assets folder above the resource folder. Here you can see, here is my website, so make sure that you have checked it. So what I'm going to do today is that I want to show this website inside the WebView, and I'm not going to add the website address over the load URL. Instead, I'm going to serve this WebView HTML and other files into this assets folder and call the assets folder into this load URL. So first I'm going to serve this. So here is the somewhere else. Also, you can press the control yes, and I'm going to save it in the desktop textatro. Okay, maybe it's called etc in lowercase. Okay, click on the save. Okay, now it's been saving. Okay, so the file is served. I'm going to close it, and here it is. So we have the two different files. One is the HTML, and here is the second, which is the resource files for this HTML. So I'm going to copy the both of the items. So you can see the first thing is a HTML file, and the second one is a folder. I'm selecting the both of them and right click, copy. Now going to the Android Studio, and we have the assets folder. Right click on the assets folder and clicking the or selecting the paste. Now just copy, press OK. So we have two different files. I'm closing these things, and now you can see under the assets folder we have the textatro underscore files. This is a folder name, and the second one is textatro.html. so I just want to call the load URL from the assets. So what I'm going to do is that we can able to directly enter the address into this assets, or we can able to create a string for that. So for the better experience, I'm going to create a new string and naming my string as textatro. That's my website name, textatro URL, and equal to, and inside this quotes, double quotes, I'm going to add. So this is the most important code that we have to listen while we are calling the URL from the URL or the HTML file from the assets. So file do, then we have to add the colon, then three slashes, that is forward slashes, then Android underscore asset, add a slash again, and type the HTML name. So that is textatro.html, including the HTML extension. Finally, we have to add the semicolon to close that. Now we have a string with the name textatro URL. I'm going to simply change the everything from the load URL bracket and replace it with the textatro. Okay, so now I have called the HTML from the assets folder. So now it can able to work without the internet connection, but enabling the internet is much better. If this HTML required any kind of external access, then it should use the internet. So I always suggest going with the internet enabled. And now I just want to show one more thing. Let's suppose you just opened the app and you go to the Textotro official page or any other websites. Then you go in more or deeper into that page and you may have to come back into the first page again. And when you press the back button, your application will be closing. And in that case, you have to create a one back preset method. And inside that, we have to set the WebView go back and something like that. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to create a new method called one back preset. So let's create an override, then public method, that is public void one back preset. Okay, so I have created a method called one back preset, and inside the braces I'm going to add something like if then WebView. Okay, so the WebView shows some errors. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to add the WebView, I'm going to remove it from here. Now I'm going to add it as WebView, then WebView. So what I have actually done is that I just declared the WebView over the above the onCreate method. Now I'm going to simply add this dot WebView. Okay, so the reason why I add the WebView over here and add the this here is to get the WebView variable into this new method, which is onBackPreset. So now we can add WebView dot then can go back, which is a kind of logic. Now we have to add a braces, and if the WebView can go back, then WebView go back. Okay, so if the WebView can go back, it will go back. Otherwise, we have to close the application. So else finish. So what will happen when the back button is pressed, that if the WebView is gone over the home page, and if the user has gone or selected any other windows from the HTML page, then it can able to go back into this home page, and otherwise the application will be closing by the finish tag. So that's it. Now let's go and run it in a live device and check that out. Okay guys, so we have the application now in the live device and everything is working perfect, and I'm going to the next page. Now I am in the next page. I'm trying to press the back button now, and there you go, we have the home page again. And when I press the button again, you can see the application is closing. So I hope you guys got the idea, and if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and share with your friends. Also, make sure that you have subscribed. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in my next video.